Hello again, brothers and sisters in Christ. This will be the last video for me tonight. It's getting very late. Oh, Lord, forgive me. I'll just pray when I bring my dog back in. Then I don't have to be rushed. And that fresh air always perks me up a little bit anyway. It's 9:33 p.m. on the 21st. Now, this came out on the 21st from Hard News TV 2. I believe that's what it's called. Hard News TV 2, right. Okay, and it's called March 21, 2020, Urgent Military About to Take Control of the U.S. Now, this is toward the end of the video. Right now, she's got it keyed up where Obama was talking about prolonged detention. Remember when he was talking about, you may not remember, but I believe he was talking in this about terrorists coming into our country and how they could be held for prolonged detention without phone call, lawyer, trial. Okay, so just listen.
Must be prevented from attacking us again.
Prevented.
I'm going to stop it for a second.
Incarcerate people preventively. Preventive incarceration. Indefinite detention without trial. That's what this is. That's what President Obama proposed today, if you strip away the euphemisms.
Okay, so it's been planned, okay? So indefinite detention held without trial. No charges are going to be brought against you. Nobody's going to know where you're at. So then you say, oh, well, that was under Obama. Well, this was 2018 under Trump. New bipartisan bill could give any president the power to imprison U.S. citizens in military detention forever. And we just read that the government is considering to go underground and turn this whole operation over to the military. And now it's passed that, watch, one of the most outrageous acts of Barack Obama's presidency was his failure to veto the National Defense Authorization Act for fiscal year 2012. The fiscal year 2012 NDAA included provisions that appear to both codify and expand a power the executive branch had previously claimed to possess, namely the power to hold individuals, including U.S. citizens, in military detention indefinitely, based on the authorization to use military force passed by the Congress 3 days after 9/11. The New York Times warned that the bill could give future presidents the authorities to throw American citizens into prison for life without charges or trial. Okay? It says received an enormous outcry from, not surprisingly, Ron Paul. Even on the right, to Bernie Sanders.
Okay, I'm going to stop it there and just tell you that she covered it a little bit right there, but she's talking about how the president is talking about putting the National Guard in control, putting the military in control, and the Congress and all of them are going to go underground. When some people hear that, they just think, oh, they're going to go off to their vacation homes or, you know, their hideaways so they don't get this coronavirus, right? This is so more than this coronavirus. That's an excuse. That's the mirage. That's the scene they've set up. Not saying there isn't something going around that they didn't, but from what I read earlier about it being the H1N1 virus being more deadly because it followed on the heels of influenza type A that we had at the beginning of flu season, and now we're toward the end of the flu season and we're seeing influenza type B or H1N1. Okay, so whether this is that or the newly created bioweapon coronavirus, it was done for a reason. And I think they know something that's coming up. And who are they going into the dumps to hide from? They think they're going to be safe down there. And they're going to end up crying out, "Rocks fall on us." Where do you see that? Revelation chapter 6, at the end, when the great earthquake happens. They may enjoy themselves down there for a little bit. But I don't think it's going to be much longer till the rapture happens. What day is this? 3/21. Tomorrow is 3/22. Ooh. I don't know. That's a really huge number with the Illuminati. Yeah, do they have something planned? Does anybody know of anything big going on tomorrow? Besides everybody staying home, everything big has been canceled. There is nothing supposedly going on. Anyway, I'm going to let you go, and I'll put everything in the description box. Again, for those who can't see the description box, the channel is Hard News TV 2, the number 2. The title is March, M-A-R, 21, 2020, urgent, with exclamation marks after each urgent. Military about to take control of U.S. We have nothing to be afraid of. We know the one. What I just read. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of the one that can harm your body. Be afraid of the one that can take your body and your soul to hell. That's God. God is in control of your body and your soul. And yeah, Satan can kill you and take your body to hell if he can get you to turn from the Lord. And I say nobody's going to do that, are we? Say no, ma'am. All right, I plead the blood of Jesus over this video, the internet connection, and over each and every one of you. I plead the blood of Jesus over us all, and let us stay connected until we're out of here. With that, I say adios. I'm out.